गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू द प्रैक्टिकल नंबर टू। द एम ऑफ योर सेकंड प्रैक्टिकल इज राइट अ प्रोग्राम फॉर सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग एंड इन दिस वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द एक्यूरेसी बायस एंड वेरियंस। ओके, नाउ इन दिस सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग वी विल टेक वन सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ लिनियर रिग्रेशन। ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वॉट इज सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग। ओके, सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग, अनसुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग एंड री एनफोर्समेंट लर्निंग, दिस थ्री टाइप्स आर कम्स अंडर द मशीन लर्निंग। ओके, नाउ वॉट इज सुपरवाइज। इन सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग ट्रेनिंग डेटा सेट इंक्लूड्स बोथ इनपुट्स एंड आउटपुट्स। ओके, दैट मीन्स इन अवर डेटा सेट वी हैव इनपुट एंड आउटपुट ऑल्सो। ओके, अलॉन्ग विद दैट यूअर डेटा इज लेबल डेटा, दैट मीन्स इट हैज बोथ इनपुट एंड आउटपुट वेरिएबल्स। ओके, नाउ इन यूअर डेटा सेट यूअर इनपुट वेरिएबल्स आर कॉल्ड एज इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स एंड आउटपुट वेरिएबल्स आर कॉल्ड एज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल। ओके, सो यूअर इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स कैन बी मल्टीपल बट यूअर डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल मस्ट बी सिंगल। ओके, सो ऑल द इनपुट कॉलम्स आर यूअर इंडिपेंडेंट कॉलम्स एंड दे कैन बी मल्टीपल एंड यूअर आउटपुट कॉलम इज अ डिपेंडेंट कॉलम एंड विच मस्ट बी सिंगल कॉलम। ओके, लाइक हियर दिस ऑल आर द इनपुट कॉलम्स कॉल्ड एज इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स। ओके, एंड दे कैन बी मल्टीपल। नाउ दिस प्राइस इज यूअर आउटपुट कॉलम विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एंड दिस मस्ट बी अ सिंगल कॉलम। ओके, सो दिस इज एम ऑफ योर प्रैक्टिकल नंबर टू। नाउ इन सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग वी कैन यूज रिग्रेशन एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑल्सो। ओके, सो क्लासिफिकेशन कैन फाइंड आउट द एग्जैक्ट एक्यूरेसी। नाउ क्लासिफिकेशन इंक्लूड्स डिस्क्रीट डेटा, कैटेगरिकल डेटा, मेडिकल डेटा लाइक डायबिटीज, कैंसर, एंड देयर इज वन मोर, देयर आर टू मोर टाइप्स इन क्लासिफिकेशन। लाइक फर्स्ट वन इज द बाइनरी क्लासिफिकेशन, दैट मीन्स देयर आर ओनली टू वैल्यूज लाइक यस और नो, ट्रू फॉल्स इन योर टारगेट कॉलम। ओके, देन सेकंड टाइप इज दैट मल्टी क्लास क्लासिफिकेशन। सो इन मल्टी क्लास क्लासिफिकेशन देयर कैन बी वन और मोर वैल्यूज लाइक high, medium and low risks. Okay, only three values are there. This is also comes under the discrete data, that means under the classification. And regression means continuous data in target column, like we have seen in first practical price column, there is a continuous data. Okay, so let's start with the practical number two. First we have to identify problem statement. Here we will use IRIS dataset for practical number two. This is the IRIS dataset. Okay, now these all are the your input columns. That means your independent variables, and along with this column, we are going to use. This sepal length column as a target variable, as a target column. Okay, so sepal width, petal length, petal width and spacing, these all are your input columns. This sepal length cm is your output column. Okay, so what is our first step? First we have to form problem statement. Okay, so what is the problem statement here? Now your problem statement is that to predict sepal length cm values from other independent variables. We have to predict the sepal length cm value because sepal length cm is our output column. Okay, so it is our dependent variable. Our dependent variable is sepal length cm. Okay, and independent variables are sepal width, petal length cm, petal width cm and spaces. Okay, so our dependent variable is sepal length cm. Our independent variables are these four columns. Now next step is that we have to extract data set. Okay, to extract data set, what we use? Pandas library, like df equals to pd dot read csv. Write the name of data set here and print this data file. Okay. First, we have to import libraries. That's why it gives error as name pd is not defined. So first, we have to import libraries like import pandas as pd, import numpy as np. Now from sklearn dot linear model, we have to import linear regression. Okay. Now here we have to build model. We have to find out the accuracy, bias, and variance. For that, again we have to import from sklearn dot model selection, because we have to build model, and for that we have to import train test split library. Okay, and for the model evaluation, we have to use from sklearn dot matrix import R2 score, okay, which is the parameter for your accuracy. Okay, that's why we have to import R2 score from sklearn dot matrix. Now run this libraries. Now extract your data set. Now this is your CSV file. Then what is the next step? In the next step, we can find out df dot columns. Again, we can see the complete information of our data by using df dot info method. So there are total 6 columns, total 150 number of entries, that means 150 number of rows in your data set, and this is the data type. Now only your spaces column having data type object. Okay, now we have to do exploratory data analysis. This is the most important step, exploratory data analysis. Now in exploratory data analysis, we can remove some columns, we can find out unique values in our column, we can find out null values, we can fill that null values, and all these things are comes under the exploratory data analysis. Okay, so first we will find out one by one unique values in our column. So first column is the ID column. Okay, Now to find out the unit value, again we have to use df as a data frame. In square bracket, give name of that column df, and there is a function called unique. Okay, now it will return unique values. Control enter. How many unique values are there? 150 unique values are there in id column. Okay, likewise we can use value count function. Now look here, like a spaces column, here we can use value column. Again df in square bracket, write down column name spaces dot value underscore counts and run that cell. Now here you can see that in spaces column there are three unique values like iris virginica, iris setosa and iris versicola. Okay, now this is the count of unique values in that particular category. So iris virginica includes 50 unique values. This is a count of that value. Then iris setosa includes 50 and iris versicola includes 50. Okay, so in spaces there are three categories, and under these three categories this is the value count. Okay, so to count a number of values you can use values count function. Now the next step is that feature selection. Now in feature selection, if you want to remove some columns, if you want to remove or drop some columns, then you can do. But features selection is basically as per our requirements. So in the feature selection, we will select our target column. That means we will extract our target column. What is our target column? Sepal length CM. So feature selection. Now look here. First we will run our data frame. So this is our CSV data. From here sepal length CM is our target column, our output column. Okay, so now we have to build a model to find out the accuracy, bias and variance. Okay, that means we have to build a model here. For that we use train test split function, train test split library from sklearn. Okay, so listen carefully. Here I am going to take two variables like x and y. Now x equals to df dot drop. Now here we have to separate our input columns and output columns. Okay, so what I am doing, df dot drop, here use the name of your target column, that is sepal length CM. Okay, comma, axis equals to 1. Now this axis function is used for the rows and column. If axis is equals to 0, that means it refers to the rows, and if axis is equals to 1, that means it refers to columns. Now sepal length CM is your column, that's why df dot drop sepal length CM comma axis equals to 1. Now here what happens, variable x will contain all the columns except sepal length CM. Okay, because here we are dropping sepal length CM column. Okay, so from this data frame, from this data set, we are dropping this column. So your x variable will contain all the columns like id, sepal width CM, petal length CM, petal width and spaces except sepal length CM. Okay, that means we are deleting this column from our original data set. Okay, and what we are doing, we are assigning this column to another variable like y. Now to assign this to y, use df in square bracket sepal length CM. Okay, now your x will contain all the columns except sepal length CM, and your y variable will contain only single column sepal length CM. So your x is containing all the input columns and your y is containing only output column. If you want to check, we can write here y. Okay, now this y contains only the values of output column sepal length CM. Look here, 5.1, 4.9, 4.7, these all values are comes in y variable. Okay, Now we have to build our model. For that we use train, test, split function. Okay. Now look here. In train, test, split function, we have to split our data set in two categories, like training data and testing data. Okay. Now how many variables we have? We have two variables, x and y. Now we have to divide these two variables in two categories, training data and testing data. For that, we have to use x train, x test, comma, y train, y test. Okay, x train, x test, y train, y test. You have to follow this sequence, otherwise it will give you an error. Is equals to which function we are using? Train, test, split function from sklearn. Now this function, in this function we have to pass four variables. Okay, first variable is x, which is your which contains all input columns. Another variable is y, which is containing only output column. Then you have to view test size here. Like here, I am giving test size 0.2. 0.2 test size is a standard test size in companies also. They always use 0.2 test size. Okay. And then next one is the random state. Random state is equals to 1. You can give any value here, but standard value is 1. Random state 1, it means that look here, test size is 0.2. that means 20% is your testing data and 80% is your training data. Okay, so from this data set, iris data set, 80% data we are going to use to train your data set, and 20% data is used for testing your model. Okay, now it will give you random values from this 20% testing data set. These random values are given by the state size of 1. If we use here random state equals to 2, that time it will give you random values with the state size 2, with the difference of 2, with the difference of 3. Okay, it will depend on your data set. So the standard value is 1. It does not affect on your model. So always try to assign test size equals to 0.2 and random state equals to 1. Okay. So x train, x test, y train, y test. We are using a function, train test split function. Here we have pass x variable, y variable, test size is 0.2 and random state is 1. Okay. Now run this. Now we have to train our model. 80% data we will use for training the model because test size is 0.2. So model training. For model training, we are using linear regression. Okay, because our data is continuous data. So write a linear regression method. For this method, we have to create instance. That means we have to create object. So here I am creating object LR model equals to linear regression. Now after creating an instance, we have to fit that model. Okay, that means we have to fit training values. So what is our object? LR model dot fit. To fit the model, we have to use fit function. In this fit function, we have to pass two parameters like x train, comma, y train. Okay, we have to train our model. In this train test split, we are splitting our data set into two categories, training and testing. So for training our model, we have two variables, x train and y train. So we have to put that two variables in LR model. Okay, now run this. Here we are getting error because we have not done with our exploratory data analysis. The error is that could not convert string to float, that is iris versiculum. Okay, now here species dot value count. Now species dot value count is that first category contains 50 values, second contains 50, and another category contains 50 values. But here we can see that all the columns are in integer or float data type, but only the last column is in the object data type. Okay, but your computer does not understand object data type. It does not understand ABCD type data. Okay, it only understand the binary data from integer float data form. Okay, so for that, in exploratory data analysis, always check the data type of your columns, and if it is in object, that time you have to convert that column into integer or float. Okay, because your computer doesn't understand object data type, string data type. Okay, so here we have not converted it into integer or float. So for that, first we have to convert the spaces. Okay, now to convert object data type into integer or float, there is one more concept like encoding. So there are two types of encoding, like label encoding and one hot encoding. Okay, so I think you have learned within your theory subject. So we will directly conduct encoding. So to do the encoding, now here there are only three categories. So that's why here we can do label encoding. What is the difference between label encoding and one hot encoding? We use label encoding when we know the preferences of value. Okay, and we use one hot encoding when we don't know the preferences of value. Now here we can give preferences because there are only three categories. So how to use label encoding? Again, first we have to use clear. What is the name of column? Name of column is spaces dot, we have to use a replace function. Here we have to use the concept of dictionary. In Python, there is a dictionary data type. Okay, so here also we have to use the concept of dictionary. Now, the first category. Copy that. Paste here. In dictionary, the value under quotation is called as key, and after the colon called as value. Okay, it is a combination of key value pair. Okay, so here I am assigning zero value to this. Then another is that iris setosa. Write down here, and here I am giving preference as one. Then another third thing is that here I am giving preference as two. Okay, now run this set. Okay, now here you can see that your all values are converted into 0, 1, and 2 form. Okay, so first 50 values will be 0, then another will be 1, and another will be. Now run this model. We have to run it from the one more thing is remain. Here we have to write in place equals to true. Now this in place function is used. What happens if in place equals to false is by default, but if we write in place equals to true, that means the changes that we have made are reflected in your original data set. And if in place equals to true, that means in place equals to false, that means the changes that we have made are not reflected in your original data set. Now we want to convert the data type of these spaces from object to integer or float, and we want to reflect these changes in our original data set. For that, we have to write here in place equals to true. Okay, and now okay, now look here. In species, there are 0, 1, 2 values. Okay, that means the changes that we have made are reflected in our original data set. Now look here. Your species column is changed. Now again, another is that drop column. That means here we are making two variables, x variable and y variable. Then this trend test split function. Whenever you get an error, you have to run your all cells. Okay, now here you get output as a linear regression method. Okay, that means your training model has successfully learned. Now we have to do evaluation of our model. Okay, so next step is that evaluation. Now in evaluation, first we have to find out the accuracy of our data, because the aim is to identify accuracy, bias and variance. So first we will find out accuracy on testing data, and then we will find out the accuracy on training data. Okay, here in the LR model we have fit training data. Now we have to find out accuracy on both training and testing data. 20% data we are using for testing and 80% data we are using for training. So test data accuracy. Okay. Now to test data accuracy, what is our target column? Y is our target column. Okay, because Y contains the target output column. So Y pred. We have to use variable Y pred, because here we are predicting. What we are predicting? The object is LR model dot. Now we have to predict Y values by using X test data. Okay, we are testing test data accuracy. That's why here I am passing parameter as X test. What we have to find out? R2 score. Okay, now what is R2 score? I will tell you in detail in one of the theoretical session. R2 score is basically used as a parameter for calculating the accuracy. The range of your R2 score is always lies between 0 to 1. Highest the R2 score, that means highest the accuracy. Okay, so R2 value. The formula for R2 score is that Y test, comma, Y predict. Okay, I can't tell you in practical session all these terms in detail. I hope you all understood or you all learn this in your theoretical session. Okay, so the formula for R2 score is Y test minus Y predicted value. It is also called as mean squared error. To calculate mean squared error, we also use summation of Y predicted minus Y actual divided by number of samples. Okay, in R2 score we use Y test comma Y predicted. That means actual value minus predicted value. Now we have to print this R2 score. So R squared value is R2 value. Okay, and run this. Now what is the value is 0.79. This is data accuracy on testing data. Okay, now we have to do it on training data also. Then we have to follow same procedure. Now we are predicting value for training data. So LR model dot predict. Now this is testing data. That's why here I'm I have passed X test. Now this is training data accuracy. That's why here X test. Okay. Now check the value of R to score. Now on training data, we are getting accuracy as 0.88. Now here what happens, there are again two important terms like overfitting and underfitting of data. Okay, so now what happens? This is the accuracy, training data accuracy 0.88. So overfitting and underfitting means in overfitting, training data accuracy is high and testing data accuracy is low. Now here you can see the difference. Testing data accuracy is 0.75 and training data accuracy is 0.88. Okay, so that means there is a difference between training data and testing data accuracy. So whenever we get the highest accuracy on training data, that means your model is overfitted. Okay, and if we get the low accuracy on both the training data and testing data, that means your model is underfitted. Okay, so we have done with the accuracy. Then another terms that we have to do in our practical number two is that we have to identify the variance and bias. Now variance means, variance refers to the changes in model when different portion of the training data set. Okay, so in short, variance is difference between train data accuracy minus test data accuracy. Okay, so here you can easily find out the variance. That means the difference between train data accuracy and test data accuracy. Okay, then another thing is that bias. Now bias means error on training data. Okay, so whenever there is a high accuracy, your bias is always low. Okay, that means in overfitted model, you have a low bias. Okay, so here training data accuracy is high, that means your bias is low. If training data accuracy is low, that means your bias is high. So low bias and high accuracy. If there is a high bias, your accuracy will be low. Okay, so this is about the practical number 2.